eruptions, belching ash into the sky and sending lava flowing down a mountain. No reports of any casualties today. An eruption 2 years ago killed at least 17 people. Well, maybe this was just an attempt at an underwater selfie.
Quite the attempt. A shark researcher in Massachusetts got a lot closer to his subject than perhaps he wanted to Monday. Greg Skomal was swimming off Cape Cod when Great White moved in for a close-up and nibbled on the camera, a GoPro. Fortunately, the shark decided not to snack on the scientist nor the camera and swam off. I read where he said that's unusual behavior.
I would say so.
For meteorologist Janice Huff is in now, and are we still tracking rain and storms in the area?
Yes, we are, Stacy, mainly north of New York City right now. Storm Tracker 4's powerful and precise red sweep has been on the money this afternoon and showing us exactly where we've been seeing the heavy rain and the hail signatures as well. Now it's showing that most of the bigger storms have moved up through parts of central Connecticut. However, we still have a thunderstorm cell that's producing some very heavy rain right now over parts of the Bronx, southern Westchester, and into northern Nassau County. Eventually, it's moving. Flash flood warning is still in effect until 6:45 for the Bronx and northern or upper Manhattan, north of Central Park. That's where most of the heavy rain fell. Even though the rain is tapering off in these areas, there could be some residual street flooding on some of the city streets. There's the storm right now, producing some small hail near City Island. It seems to be weakening a bit, but there's still some pretty steady rain right now, moving towards Manor Haven along I-95. This storm extends a bit to the towards Great Neck now, and parts of the LIE might get clipped by this as it moves off to the east. So this is where we're seeing it now. Everything's moving off to the north and east now. So Long Island, you'll get a chance of damage. Most of that activity has weakened or moved on. Still seeing a big cell with some very heavy rain right now moving near Milford, Connecticut. Towards Trumbull, we're seeing another heavy thunderstorm cell. Some heavy rain there. Could see some street flooding with these. Look at that. It's intensified a bit just south of Shelton, Connecticut, moving off to the north and east. How much rain so far? Poughkeepsie checked in with about 1.5 inches of rain from thunderstorms earlier this afternoon. And then we look at Central Park that only measured 0.1 inch compared to Newark with almost 1 inch, and nothing measurable at Islip today because you haven't seen any rain yet. Caldwell with just under 2 inches. Meanwhile, Toms River, nothing. So you can see how widely scattered these storms were, but they were intense where they formed and moved on. The airport delays are monstrous. We've got just over 3-hour delays at JFK. This is all because of the thunderstorms and strong winds. Once everything moves out of the area and the winds calm down, they'll get back to business at the area airports. In the meantime, temperatures are in the 70s to around 80. Only one 80-degree temperature here. That's Northport. East of Tawkins at 81. Most areas have cooled down considerably where you've had the thunderstorms and the hail. Now in Poughkeepsie, so very cool. The city's down to 70 degrees, and that's where we'll stay for the rest of this evening. The storm's dying out tomorrow. You could see a few isolated ones pop up, but probably 82. Another chance for storms on Saturday, but Sunday looks nice. That's going to be the better day of the weekend as we have low humidity and plenty of sunshine. We'll update you on the activity coming up at 6 o'clock. That's out there. Janice Huff is tracking Maria with the latest on what it's doing now, Janice. Well, Stacey, right now the storm is in the Atlantic and it's moving towards the Turks and Caicos. So with a Category 3 strength, and they're starting to feel tropical storm conditions there already, likely to feel hurricane conditions there later on tonight. Still some big heavy rain over the Dominican Republic, expecting probably another 6 to 15 inches. And even the western sections of Puerto Rico getting some heavy rain and some flash flooding still on the backside of it. But the storm is moving away from the area. Now, Maria's top wind.